brought to you by 1AAuto.com, your source for quality replacement parts and the best service on the internet.
Hi, I'm Mike from 1AAuto. I hope this how-to video helps you out. And next time you need parts for your vehicle, think of 1AAuto.com. Thanks.
In this video, we're going to show you how to replace the rear door lock actuator on this 2005 Ford F-150. Same part and similar process on these F-150s from 2004 to 2008. And we show you on the driver's side, but the passenger side is the same procedure. And the items that you'll need for this is a new rear door lock actuator from 1AAuto.com, a 6, 8, and 10 millimeter socket and ratchet with an extension, flat blade screwdriver, T25 Torx bit, and a 5.5 millimeter socket or a 7/32 socket. Pry out on this small panel behind the door handle, and then pry up on this panel. Just pull it forward, lift it up, and then push the tab on this harness and disconnect it. Then pull out on this panel and pull it free. And it helps to use the flat blade screwdriver to just kind of pry it free. I remove this 6 millimeter bolt, these 2 8 millimeter bolts, this 10 millimeter bolt, and then these 2 6 millimeter bolts down here. And we'll just fast forward as Mike does that. Now lift the door panel up and pull it out. And then you want to pull out your door handle cable, and it's easiest with a flat blade screwdriver. Just pry it out and then unclip it from the door handle, and your door panel's free. Now remove these 5.5 millimeter or 7/32 bolts from your speaker, and you may notice that we've switched doors. We're just going to show you the procedure on this door that actually has a water shield. Pull your speaker out and then just push the tab on the harness and disconnect it. And then just peel back your water shield. Now remove this 10 millimeter bolt. And just pull that bracket out. Now reach back here, and with a flat blade screwdriver, you want to just pry this green clip open. Then pull the rod out. Now remove these 3 T25 Torx screws, and we'll just fast forward as Mike does that. Now you want to just pull these clips out, just push the tabs on the back and pull them free.
You just reach in and try and squeeze the tabs together on the back side and pull.
And now just work your door lock actuator assembly down and out. And it does take some maneuvering to get it to come out, but just keep working at it and it will come out. Push in on the tabs on these harnesses and disconnect them. And then using a flat blade screwdriver, just pry up on this tab and slide your door lock actuator forward. And it'll pull free. On the bottom is the old door lock actuator. Above it is the new one from 1A Auto. You can see they're identical and they'll fit exactly the same.
This part locks in, so you may want to just kind of
flex it out a little bit. Slide it down into place. Make sure that your arm is going in there. Lock it in.
Reconnect the harnesses. Make sure they're connected all the way, and then feed the door latch assembly back into the door. And make sure you push the lock rod up through the door. And to help hold the latch assembly into place, you just clip on the child lock into the door and replace one of those T25 screws just preliminarily right now to hold it in place. Make sure you push those yellow clips on the cable back end and then replace and tighten up those three T25 screws. Now just put the door handle rod back into that green clip and reclip it. And then take this bracket, put it back into place, and replace and tighten up that 10mm bolt. Now replace your water shield. Reconnect your speaker, push it back into place, and then replace those four 5.5mm bolts and tighten them up. To replace your door panel, just reclip the door handle cable into the door handle and then push it back into place. Make sure these clips stay into the door. And then line up the tabs on the back. And make sure that the lock rod goes up through the door panel and that your harness for your window switch is coming up through that hole in the door panel. And then push the door panel down into place. And we'll fast forward as Mike replaces all of those bolts. Now replace the small panel behind the door handle, reconnect to your window switch, push those tabs into place, and push the panel back down. Then line this panel up, slide it down into the door panel, and push those two clips back into place. You're all set.
We hope this video helps you out. Brought to you by 1AAuto.com, your source for quality replacement parts and the best service on the internet. Please feel free to call us toll-free, 888-844-3393. We're the company that's here for you on the internet and in person.